devotionals for this second week of Advent as we prepare our hearts for the third Sunday of Advent. Here on Wednesday, I wish that you all who are joining us for worship in this season online could see these beautiful banners that we have just a bit better. These are some of my favorite banners that WCPC has. And each year, David likes to give a children's message about these banners. He likes to remind our children, using these banners, of the symbolism that they contain. He reminds them that just as Jesus was born in Bethlehem and was a gift then, when we look at the other banner, which we will do in a minute, we are reminded that part of what we remember in Advent and in the season of Christmas is that Christ has come as a gift for us too. Part of what we're waiting for in Advent is for his coming again. In this season, it becomes more obvious to us that we live in a time that is between. A time between Bethlehem and today. Just like these banners remind us. And so today we hear from Paul's letter to the Thessalonians, the first letter in the fifth chapter. Rejoice always, pray again without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the Spirit, do not despise the word of the prophets, but test everything. Hold fast to what is good, abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely. May your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. Here we are at the second banner, the banner that reminds us that Christ is not just a gift of the past, but that Christ is a gift for us today. In writing about this passage in the Feasting on the Word devotional, commentator W.C. Turner says, on the one hand, the church is called to live in full expectancy of the Lord's return. This is what keeps us ready, busy, on the post of duty. The expectation has the world and all to do with the urgency of mission, ministry, and mission. Or lack thereof. On the other hand, he continues, the church must live as if the Lord is dependent on it indefinitely. For its ongoing life, it must care for matters that are mundane, like seeing to it that the servants receive their care, that the altar or chancel or table we Presbyterians might say are tended to, that the property is kept up, that schedules are made and observed. No one fit of piety, emotion, or sincerity takes the place of such vigilance. Friends, we live in this both and time as we wait this Advent. And we do so in constant prayer and with great joy. Let us pray. God of now and God of then, help us to look back with joy and with remembrance, and to look forward with prayer and with hope. Help us in all these things to give thanks to you for what you have done, for what you are doing,